Well, we're at the Garmseer District Center, where the district governor and many of his directors of various functional specialties, education, health, etc., work. And the gate to the compound, it collapsed. It was rather narrow, and a couple of vehicles hit it over time, fell down. And mostly it's a safety hazard, of course, so it needs to be reconstructed. We can't have rubble laying around, and rubble laying around is also not just safety hazard, but also an appearance issue. The people should see that their government is capable of, fixing its own buildings and such. It lends dignity to the office, and we're going to help get it done quickly. So I was able to speak with a local contractor, got a decent price, and we started work pretty quickly. The local business contractors, there's a pretty good database of them that I have. So it was fairly easy for me to notify two or three of them that I have a project that needs to be worked on. They just came out, did an assessment, quickly got back to me within about a day, and I picked the best option and told them to start working. Because this is what's called a Commander small scale project or quick impact project, it's less than 5,000, and therefore we don't need to run the proposal up the chain of command. It's sufficiently inexpensive that we can just move forward with the work when we decide. It's a lot of trial and error, but most of that has already happened. My predecessors, the civil affairs team leaders that were here over the past year, they've gotten to know a lot of the contractors and their reputations by doing small projects with them, and they turn that information over to me, and I'm able to benefit from their hard work. Like I mentioned, it's important for safety and the dignity of the Afghan government, the district of Garmseer government. It means we're making progress, like we've been promising the people of Afghanistan. It's little things every day that will allow us to make the large leaps in progress over time. And it is a fairly small task to rebuild a wall and a gate, but again, it's those little building blocks that will eventually create a large and sustainable, tangible progress that we hope to, which is our purpose for being here. Naturally, as you might guess, it's more beneficial for them to have money infused into their local economy, to continue to build up their skills all the basic trades that are necessary to keep a country functioning, and engineering, construction, that's one of them. So they pretty much do it all themselves. It's possible that we could get the supplies for them, but rarely do we do that. For the most part, they have better access, that they know what subcontractors to talk to, or wholesale construction material folks to talk to. Big thing is it keeps it local, so that the people, they're not getting cynical. They would get cynical, I think, if all they saw was outsiders coming in, whether they're from Pakistan or Kandahar or Kabul, just coming in and making money, and the local people here of Hazar Joft or Garmseer are getting no benefit from that. They benefit from the infrastructure, but it that's important, but more so it's important that there's money in the local economy to keep it running. To quite a large extent, it helps them. It's putting our words into action. They can truly see as well as believe that we're here to help them. We're not here to hurt them. We're not trying to take advantage of their country. We're trying to just give them the boost they need to rebuild after 30 years of war, 30 plus years of war. So it's putting our money where our mouth is, almost literally. We have a few on the table. I can't really speak too in depth because they're very much in the embryonic stage, plus in the other parts of the district where my Marines are now. I'm slowly getting information about what quick impact projects they see as being necessary. So Yes, yeah, in the same way that I coordinate with the rest of the battalion. At their level, they coordinate with the Marines in the company and get feedback from them, work with the commander to find out what his priorities are, how they can enable that, and from there they pick what will, well, in conjunction with the local leadership and the people's input as well, they pick what will most benefit the people and press forward.